Oh, wow. Hey, God bless you. Thanks for dropping in. Oh, there's a good word here. I'd like to ask you to join me and let's fellowship together on this edition of the Prophetic Chronicles. Talk to you in a minute. Turn to Ephesians chapter 6, and we're going to read verses 12 through 18. Actually, I'm allowed by the Lord to start at verse 10 to go to verse 18. Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand. Stand therefore, having your loins girt about with truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness, and your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked, and take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, capital S, meaning the sword of the Holy Ghost, which is the Word of God. Praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, capital S, the Holy Ghost, meaning those of us that are Holy Ghost filled, with the biblical evidence of speaking in other tongues, not chanting, but speaking in other tongues. It's important to pray in the Spirit often. Let me read verse 18 again. Praying always, see, not sometimes, but always, with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, capital S, and watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all saints. Verse 19, throw that in there, says, and for me, that utterance may be given unto me, that I may open my mouth boldly to make known the mystery of the gospel, the thought that the Holy Ghost has given me for this little talk is called Pulling Down Strongholds Isn't for Amateurs. The title is, The Fight is Won When the Answers Come, because there's no substitute for victory. Let us pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we come before you asking you to forgive us for our sins, for our shortcomings, for our faults and for our wrongs. Lord, some of us are fasting. Some of us are just simply praying. I ask you, Lord, to fill me with the word of wisdom, the word of knowledge. Give me a spiritual understanding of your word. Bless us right now, this late, late night hour, to come before you, to hear from you, to discern what you are saying. Sharpen our gifts, intensify them, magnify the anointing on our lives. impart wisdom unto all of us, that we should understand this battle that we're in, this fight that we are in. And I ask, Lord, that you just lead us in prayer after the meat of this lesson is served, the platter, the side orders, the beverage. And Father, just lead us in prayer then, that we may rebuke the devil, that we may get the victory that thou hast promised us. Many of us are watching you. Many of us have our eyes set on you. Many of us that have read the scriptures and still read the scriptures, we're holding you to your word. No one can do what you do. No one can bless like you bless. No one can open doors like you open doors. No one can speak a word with everyone and everything obeying them but you. You know our beginning. You know our end. You know how our lives are going to turn out. We ask you, Father, to have mercy on us since we don't know. We are not infinite, but we are finite. We are not limitless, but we are limited. We don't put no confidence in the flesh, nor do we put confidence in our own selves. But our faith, our confidence is in you. Now talk to us. You said men ought to always pray. Well, that's a two-sided conversation with you. We're putting out our part now. We're asking you to respond. Thou hast said unto me, you are standing on holy ground. Take off thy shoes. Not just me, but to my brethren and my sisters that are in the ministry. Right now, wherever we are, we take off our shoes. For we are standing on holy ground. We dare not tread on holy ground with dirty feet. We come before you asking you, Holy Ghost, to talk to you. Use your apostle as a prophet this early morning. Tell me what to say, and it'll be said. Please. And talk to me also. Minister to us. You said there's no substitute for victory. And that's what we're waiting for. Victory. So help us and strengthen us. Those of us that are on a fast, like you have me right now, strengthen us as we're fasting. We are denying ourselves things that we desire, that our spirit man may get close to you and tap into you. We are fasting for people, places, or things. Some of us also fasting for ourselves. So we're asking you, Father, to hear us, to bless this fast, to be successful. It's not over until the angel comes with the answer. So while there's angels and demons fighting in the heavenlies, help us to stand on our post and not to get off, not one inch, until the blessing comes. We have a praise that's boiling up inside of us, that's ready to come out. But Lord, when you move, when you answer, when you bring our prayer list down to zero, meaning when everything has a check next to it, saying that you have done what you said you're going to do, we will praise you. Oh, we'll praise you. We'll praise you. Have mercy. In Jesus' mighty name, we thank you and we pray. Amen. Amen and amen. Wow, that was deep. That was deep and such a blessing. Thanks for joining me. And I look forward to seeing you the next time where we dip back into the library to notice the Prophetic Chronicles. God bless you and enjoy your day.